If you haven't seen Transformers Dark of the Moon yet, don't listen to the rest of this review because it is filled with spoilers.
If you don't really care, why are you listening to this? So I've seen Transformers Dark of the Moon a couple of times now. The first time was in regular 2D. Then over the weekend, I finally did see it in IMAX 3D. This, like I said, is going to be spoiler-filled. So those of you who haven't seen it, one more warning. Turn away now. Still here? Good. Here we go. Well, how can we talk Transformers and not have that playing behind us? Okay, so let's get to it. Let's keep it short and sweet. Spoiler filled, though, but short and sweet. So here it is. Basically, what works with this movie? Just about everything, quite honestly. Don't have a lot of complaints about it. The only two complaints I have are the same ones that I have in a spoiler-free review. And one is, this song playing behind me is nowhere to be found. It is missed. The second is also a complaint I had since the first Transformers movie and into Revenge of the Fallen and into this one. Too many Decepticons. There's only, what, about 8-9 Autobots, and a lot of them get killed during during this movie. But it seems, especially in this one, it seems like there's thousands of Decepticons all over the world. How can you win a war when you only have 8 soldiers and there's like thousands of against you? Okay, I know it's done in Hollywood, but come on. And yeah, it is me asking for believability in a Transformers movie. What is wrong with me? Like I said, not too much doesn't work in this film. The annoying parts from Revenge of the Fallen are still here, but they're really toned down a lot. The scene either cuts off abruptly or the character gets killed. Even better. The explosions are big, they're huge. The IMAX 3D, honestly, did not work for me. I'm still not sold on this 3D thing. I found myself trying, not knowing where to focus. And I'm not talking about the action scenes, I'm talking about just the scenes where there's two characters talking to each other. They're in front of the main focus of the picture, but you also have a coffee cup, you also have dust particles, you also have lens flares, all that stuff, and your eye doesn't know where to focus on because there's so much stuff coming at you, literally. It's just too much. So I'm still not sold on the 3D thing. Now you go into looking for a story, it's pretty straightforward at this time, but again, why are you looking for a story in a movie about toys? Same thing I said to people who said, there's no story in G.I. Joe. But this time around, the story is pretty straightforward. The Decepticons are trying to build a space bridge to bring Cybertron here. Not really sure, maybe I missed something, but not really sure why they need to bring Cybertron here. The new character, Sentinel Prime, is pretty cool. Awesomely voiced by Leonard Nimoy, of course. And check out, there's a couple of nods to Spock in there. One is an obvious, because it's Spock on a television that Sam's watching. The other, Star Trek fans, you'll love this one. Star Trek 2 fans, especially. You will love this one. There's a line from Star Trek 2 that you will right away. But again, everything works. The other thing that did not work for most of my audience that I saw, because it was a packed house on IMAX when I saw it over the weekend, the end. It wasn't a gasp like last year for Inception, where everybody gasped when the totem didn't fall. But it was a good one because they were, to this day, they're still talking about it. This one, it's, the movie's going on, the battle finishes, and everything's, how they usually have that wrap up with Peter Cullen's phenomenal voice giving us some kind of lecture and pretty much saying we'll see you next year or a couple of years whenever the next Transformers is coming out. This time, first of all, it's a well-known fact that this is Michael Bay's last one, so he says, but it ends pretty abruptly, a little too abruptly, I would think. Doesn't really leave it open or closed for anything. It just Optimus is talking and it's like they're hurrying up to finish it. They cut it off and that's it. There's one scene after the credits, if you want to stay. It's doesn't really add or subtract from the story, so it's just there. If you want to see it, stick around. So bottom line is Transformers Dark of the Moon is a very good movie. It's an enjoyable movie. It's not perfect by any means, but if you're just going in there to be entertained and watch robots blow up and everything blow up around you, then this is the movie for you. As far as IMAX 3D or regular, again, your choice. I told you, this is just me. This is probably just my eyes. I had a hard time focusing on some of the scenes, whether to focus on the two characters speaking. I'm not talking about the action scenes. And actually, to be quite honest with you, the action scenes were pretty easy to follow in IMAX 3D. I thought it was going to be just a convoluted mess of gears and stuff flying around. It's pretty easy to follow in this one. It's actually the scenes I'm talking about are actually the speaking scenes where there's no action, nothing going on except two characters talking. It's kind of hard to focus on either a coffee cup in front of you or dust particles. The lens flares are there. All kinds of stuff coming at you. It's just too much for me. But if you don't care about that, then go ahead and see it in IMAX 3D. Either one gives you the same effect. Story is the same. Story doesn't change anything. So next week we have kind of a break as far as big summer movies go. Then in a couple of weeks we have a little movie about a wizard. So be on the lookout for that review. I'll do two, spoiler free and spoiler filled. So be on the lookout for that. Oh, I may have one also. There is another movie that came out this weekend, believe it or not. It's from one of my favorite actors, Tom Hanks, Larry Crown. I'll go see that sometime this week and let you all know what that is about. So I'll talk to you all in a couple of weeks with another Geek Speak Radio Show movie review.